Imagine you are in a seminar or a group coaching, and after all the important stuff has been discussed, and now the room is open for questions. Do you remember that feeling you've had when you want to ask a question, but then you're too afraid to raise your hands and ask a question? It's almost like a battle in your head. You have this amazing question to ask, but you don't have the confidence to raise your hand and ask that question. Hey everyone, my name is Joel, and I help children and young adults get ready for their future by helping them with their personal development, confidence, and career planning. And today we are discussing how to break fear and rise up in confidence. Come on, you have something important to say, and what you say will bring great value to the conversation. But you know what? You don't have the confidence to raise your hands and ask why. And you know what, dear friends? You exactly know why. It's your fear. The fear of being judged, fear of making a mistake, fear of the unknown, fear of the things that what would happen if you only opened your mouth and said what you wanted to say. And this fear is not something that's new to you, dear friends. This fear has been following you for a long time. And in fact, the same fear had been following me for a long time too. I remember back in days when I was in school, asking a question was not easy for me. Asking a question was the most scariest thing. You know, I did not have the guts to ask for help or even answer the questions that my teachers would ask me, even though I thought that I knew it. But then there was always a sense of a doubt. What if I'm wrong? What if that's not the right answer? What if my friends think I'm not as good as them? Dear parents, these are the questions children battle in their head. These are the questions that they battle in their school life. Children battle with a lack of self-awareness, a lack of not knowing their true worth, not knowing their true potential. Now, all of these, this lack of self-awareness leaves the child doubting themselves. And if this doubt is unchecked, you know what happens? This doubt becomes a pattern, a habit, and that's the way that becomes so normal that the children end up believing that they are not cut out for any great thing. Yes, they may do a little bit of here and there and achieve some average, slightly higher to the average side, you know, but then they ultimately know that they are not cut out for anything great, or they can't really do anything achievable. You know what, dear friends, this is not what we are wanting to see out of our children. We want children who are confident, who are able to face up to any challenge and know that they can solve the problem. That's how we want to raise up our children.